Praise be to God. Daily One Missionary Biography. Today's missionary, James Renwick. Date of birth, 15-16-62. Home calling, 17-16-88. Native place, Monive, Scotland. Mission, Scotland. James Renwick was a Scottish Presbyterian minister who became a martyr for Christ for his radical obedience to the Word of God. Born into a pious family, Renwick had a strong affinity towards church activities from a very early age. At the age of 13, he went to the University of Edinburgh, where he studied religion and theology. There he was drawn towards Richard Cameron's teachings, who was killed for resisting King Charles II to impose the bishop's authority on the Scotland Church. Later, he went to the Netherlands for theological training, where he was ordained as a church minister. Renwick returned to Scotland in 1683 and started serving the Lord boldly when Presbyterians were killed for rejecting the Crown's attempts to control the church. In his first year of the ministry, he brought more than 500 people into the knowledge of Christ. For the next 5 years, he traveled throughout Scotland preaching biblical truth to anyone who would listen. Eventually declared a rebel, he was in constant pursuit by the authorities. Despite the risk of being arrested, he continued preaching. There was always a horse standing by saddle and bridle so that he could make a swift getaway. After escaping multiple close shaves with death, Renwick was ultimately captured in early 1688. Placed on trial, he was sentenced to die for treason and blasphemy. When several people persuaded him to accept at least some authority of the king, he refused, saying, "No, I will own authority that has its prescriptions and limitations from the Word of God." The army captain, astonished to see Renwick, a man with a slight build and youthful look, bravely walking towards gallows, and said, "What is this, the boy Renwick, that the nation has been so much troubled with?" Do you know how old was Renwick when he was hanged? 26. Renwick continues to inspire us through his sermons and letters now published as tracts and pamphlets. Dear, is your youth a worthy use for the Lord? Lord, help me to make use of my youth worthily for you. Amen. God bless you.